Hello, friends. Welcome or welcome back. I am Scensationals by Leanne, and I am going to go through my wax that I finished up from the month of February. First off, thank you for stopping by and being interested in what I melted. I noticed that there aren't a lot more videos for me from this point on because I just stopped purchasing from Wax, and that is like my total resolve for this year, is to not purchase anymore and just to go through my collection and stash, which is plenty to hold me down for the next decade or so. So I do have a haircut too. I wanted to have my hair shorter. It's just a lot more easier. I mean, I feel like I can breathe a bit better too. I just like having short hair in general. And I chopped it off myself, and I did make some mistakes. And my sweet husband, who has no experience, helped to make it more even. But I probably should have went to the salon to get it chopped up, but I was just too cheap to do that because purchasing so much wax leaves like little to no room in my budget, really. But I like my haircut. It's so much better to have shorter hair. It's so much better for me to have shorter hair. I just find it a lot more easier to manage. And I hope you're all doing well. So let's go through my my monthly wax empties. Let's start off with the vendors first. Let's start off with L3. And goodness, there's so many changes to this year. And some of these vendors are just not having it. And it's unfortunate to see it go a little bit south. But I believe that changes are necessary for whatever future is in store for you, and we shall pick it up from where we started, and we shouldn't give up. We should just keep on going. So L3 Waxy Wonders, I'll go through my large scoop and get toasted. I know this is my last scoop and get toasted. And I definitely finished the three scoops that I picked up from last year. So this is S'mores, Espresso, and Bonfire. Really strong scoop. Probably the strongest scoop that I've melted so far. No, it is the strongest scoop that I've melted so far. You only need a little bit of this for me to get the throw that I wanted. It was a bit much, but I loved it when it was mixed with other bakery. So it gave like a smoky chocolate element to the bakery that I was melting. I'm definitely getting chocolate here, but like a chocolate fire is what I get from here. And I enjoyed the scoop when it lasted. It definitely grew on me the more I melted it. And I was kind of bummed to see that the last scoop to go, but it was necessary. I have so many smoky, fiery scent scoops in my stash. So that one is gone. Another from L3 Waxy Wonders is Baccarat Rouge 540 and Cashmere Cedar. I've melted this in my bedroom. And throw-wise, I give it like a 6 to 7 out of 10. I'm definitely getting that perfumey Baccarat Rouge, but then it's also mixed in with a little bit of woodsy coming in from the cashmere cedar. I find that it is a great balance of the two. It's a bit perfumey, sweet, and a little woodsy. And that was great for my bedroom. Finished up this bitty bitty loaf in that. There it is. My last thing from L3 Waxy Wonders is Cafe C Spiced Oat Milk. It was in the puppy packs. I definitely enjoy this in the mornings, and I like to melt like cafe or coffee scents in the mornings. This one, it wasn't strong on the coffee, but it was a very nice spicy oat milk. So it was a little creamy kind of scent, a little grain in the background. It was definitely cozy, comforting, and I'd say this is a very bakery scent, but the coffee does not stand out more. It's a light coffee scent in the background. That's it for my L3 Waxy Wonders wax, and I'm trying to hold off on purchasing any more wax because I do have some things and goals I want to try and do this year. Like I'm traveling more with my family, and I plan to like do an overseas trip to the Philippines maybe towards the end of this year. So it's a lot of budgeting for me to go through. And yeah, so let's move on to Knowles Farm Scents. And this was a whole thing loaf and warm the soul. This was my last loaf and warm the soul that I finished. I liked it. It performed. So now it's getting a little warmer. I find it's performing better, like it's throwing better. So I'm definitely getting away with it just being in my hot plate warmers, like a small chunk of a loaf. And I'm definitely getting some performance there, like a medium strong performer. It will last throughout the entire day. But the scent notes here are by the fireplace, Palo Santo, and zucchini bread. I'm getting mostly zucchini bread more than I'm getting like by the fireplace and Palo Santo. But I also mixed it with like smoky fiery scents, like Get Toasted, and then another scoop from L3, which is Winter Nights. That's a very fiery, smoky blend, and it just definitely brought out the smoky, fiery aspect to this. And it's just such a nice, cozy bakery scent. It's not so sweet, more like a bread kind of scent. And this one here next is okay. That's it for Knowles Farm scents. This one here from Sassy Go Aroma, I finished up a Brittle and Radiant Leaves. I had this melting in the office, and it is a crisp red Macintosh apple, smoky notes of sweet maple, warm caramel, and an aromatic woody notes. I purchased two Brittles of this, and because I thought based on the notes is something I would like. It sounds really earthy, right? Like with the woody notes and smoky maple warm caramel and the sweetness from Macintosh apple. But what I got, I'm not sure if everyone else gets this, but for me, I got more like a sweet bubblegum scent off of this. And I actually liked it. I enjoyed it when it was melting. I like my sweet scents, but it was like, for me, I got bubblegum. And I have one more brittle of this, and I'm also melting through that one, but I kind of wanted to savor it a little bit, so I took a break from that and started melting other things. But yeah, I enjoy Radiant Leaves from Sassy Go Aroma. And lastly, from Vendors, are my scent shots from Candles by Victoria. I melted strawberry shortcake downstairs. It was a nice strawberry scent. It's like a buttery artificial strawberry scent. Like the shortcake is a little buttery cake here. And then like a very sweet strawberry. I liked it. Maybe not my favorite, but I enjoyed this. I enjoy my strawberry scents. I have here our caramel brulee latte. And I'm mostly getting a caramel. And latte is, I would say, correct in the sense that it's not strong in the coffee. I'm getting mostly caramel. I'm trying to detect if there's like any milky notes here. No, I'm mostly getting like caramel candy, like that artificial caramel candy scent here. Yeah, so that is caramel brulee latte. Next one here from Candles by Victoria is caramel coffee cake. Oh, the throw on that is like 7 out of 10. Her stuff throws pretty strong, but it doesn't last, in my opinion. Okay, so this one is caramel coffee cake. Now this one, coffee is there. I can smell the coffee and caramel. Not so much the cake, but I'm definitely getting like a caramel coffee scent here. And throw-wise, it's like 7, 8 out of 10, but it would last like maybe less than half the day. So like 4 to 6 hours at the very most, probably 4 hours. And that is Candles by, oh, no, one more. Coffee a lot zucchini bread. This was my favorite scent that I melted from Kennels by Victoria and finished in the last month. Oh, this one. If I were to repurchase from Kennels by Victoria, this would be one of them. The Cafe Au Lait Zucchini Bread. I'm definitely getting like a creamy, sweet coffee scent. It's not so it is roasty, but it's like sweet and creamy too. And the zucchini bread adds like a nice sweet bakery aspect to this. This is magical to me and definitely one of my favorites from Kennels by Victoria. Repurchase worthy. Okay, lastly I have our clam shells from Scensationals and is Better Homes and Gardens. I love my Walmart wax. They perform so well and are such a great value. So I find myself not reaching or buying vendors as much is because like there are a lot of things out there too that are just as good. So this Better Homes and Gardens is cranberry and allspice. Yeah, I wanted to finish this one. It's like a very fruity, I'm getting fruity scents of cranberry. And that to me smells like a tart berry scent. And then I'm getting like spicy notes here. So it was a nice, bright, uplifting, spicy scent. I like this. It was comforting and bright at the same time. And throw-wise, that would be like a 7 to 8 and would last the entire day. This one here, I melted rain, water, and moss from Better Homes and Gardens in the office. So this one smells like... So the notes here are rainwater, lotus, lavender, red cedar, frosted patchouli, and moss scent notes. Smells like soap to me. Like a masculine, clean soap is what I get from this. Yes, it's very soapy, but then that like that moss peeks through. Like that earthy plant scent peeks through here. But it's definitely like clean and soapy. And that is rainwater and moss. I would not repurchase this. I find others that I like more. This one here is a household favorite from my daughter, Scensationals Hello Gorgeous. I have several packs of this and I've gone through another one this month. This is vanilla rose and pink pear. Very perfumey, floral, fruity scent, but it's not overly floral or fruity. Like that pear just rounds out that floral scent and adds a bit of sweetness to this. I really like this. It's also reminds me a lot of... It reminds me, but it's not identical. I'm not saying it's identical. It just reminds me of Black Rot Rouge 540 or Ariana Cloud Grande. Let's see. Also, it's another... I haven't worn this other perfume in a while, but I think it also reminded me of Mancera Vanilla Rose perfume. I like this scent. I had it going in my light bulb warmer in my bathroom, and it gave off a nice light medium throw. Like, I would say 3 to 4 throw in my bathroom. But it would last for like 2 days. Oh, there's my alarm. Okay, Google, stop. Lastly, I have is the Scensationals Big Value Pack in Vanilla Pine. This is a very nice tree perfumey. Like that vanilla, I feel like it's like a more like a perfumey vanilla, and then I get like tree. This is Vanilla Pine. I just had this going downstairs mixed in with like bakery that I had going on. Just throwing whatever in there just to use up my wax. But I do enjoy my tree scents and I like this. I don't know if I would repurchase because I have a lot of tree wood scents in my stash. But this is quite nice. If I was low on trees, I'd get this, I think. And I think it would be better if you mixed it with cookies and things like that. That is it for my wax empties, and I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm just gonna pop in here and there now. Not as much, probably just mostly for my wax empties, just to share with all of you what I melted for the past month. Yes, and yeah, I'm a little behind on this video, and it's like almost mid-March. But I definitely went and filmed this, so now I can go ahead and put it all away and get it ready for my next empties that I have going on for that I'm melting this month. And I hope you're doing well. I hope you've enjoyed this, and thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a great week, and I hope you have a great weekend, and I hope you stay safe and take care. And see you all later. Bye.